Okay, it's time to take a look at this SQ8 mini DV camera that I opened last week in my my mailbag. And well, I've been playing for it a week, and I'm going to show you some of the footage that I took and my basic reactions and whatnot. And it's not really a review. I guess you can call it that if you want to. But first of all, how do you think it works in a well-lit environment like this here? Well, you don't have to wonder, because you've been looking at it and listening to it. It's not horrible, actually. Just shut it off here. So the first impression that I have is, oh, it's so cute and tiny. But I mean, it was something this tiny, there's going to be some drawbacks, but it is actually not that bad, especially for the money. And so the two video modes got 720, 30 frames per second and 1080, 30 frames per second. A lot of cheap cameras don't, they do have the higher, resolution, but they drop frame rate to do it. And some, that I've actually played with say their 720p is actually 60 frames per second. But when you look at the file, it's actually, the file is 60 frames per second, but the data in it is only 30 frames per second. So this one's not trying to bullshit you. It is actually 30 frames per second. What other things? It's the other mode is pictures, 12 megapixels, it says. That is kind of a bullshit. It may have that many, but it's grainy as hell. I mean, take a look at this picture of my dog out in the yard. This was on a well-lit day. And when you're seeing it full screen like this, it's not horrible for a cheap camera, but when you zoom in, that's just horrible. So not going to want to use it as a still camera, except for in an emergency, if this is the only thing I've got. Plus, so that's kind of a downside, but it's not a big hairy deal. Plus the user interface with only two buttons and only one indicator, which is this here, LED in the corner here. Let me turn it on. That's the only indicator there is. It blinks patterns at you. For instance, that blink that it did a second ago when I turned it on tells you that it's ready to go. And the color that it is right now, blue, means it's ready in 720 mode. So if I just tap the button, it blinks at you three times and then goes dark. It is now currently recording in 720 mode. I tap for another second or so, it comes back. It's in standby mode. The mode switch up here takes it to the different modes. If I push it once, it claims to go purple. I don't know whether you can see the difference or not, but now if I push this button for a second, it blinks at you and goes dark again. Now it's recording in 1080. So I'm just going to back up here and record the scene on my bench here. Hopefully I can see it all in 1080. I'll switch over for a second and just let you see it. Because I'm editing and uploading this video, like all my videos, in 720, you're probably not going to see a big difference. So that done, tap that button, it comes back on in solid standby. If I bump that one more time, the mode button one more time, it's supposed to go into still photo mode. And if I tap it one more time, it's back in 720 mode. That's supposed to be still picture mode. And actually, let me take a still picture of this scene here. Okay, so that should have taken a still picture down on the bench here. I'll tap that one more time. It's back in that mode. Now there is another mode available, is infrared. So if I push the on-off button for 2 seconds, like if I push it for 1 second, it goes into record mode like that. But if I push and hold for one, two, now it blinks red and then back to blue, and it should be an infrared, and you should be able to see that the infrared LEDs are all lit up through the camera. In real life, I can't see that, but through the camera lens, you can see that it's in infrared mode. And now then, I can, and it's in 720 because that's blue. So I just do that, blink, blink, blink. Okay, now just stand by for a second. I'm going to turn off the lights in the room here, and we'll see what it looks like. Okay, and I guess do this properly. Let's unplug that guy. So there's a bit of light coming in from the hallway. But I've got the little camera held up beside my main camera right now. And there's all the main camera. I can see the infrared LEDs. When I put this up here, it's actually kind of not bad. All right, so that's the basic modes that this guy has. Let's shut them off here. So the accessories that came with it, as I showed in the other video, in the unboxing video, or not the mailbag video, there's this little clippy thing that goes onto the back, and you can clip it onto stuff. And that's sort of okay, but when you if you clip it onto clothes, it's front heavy. It dangles down like that. So unless you got something really secure, and I actually clipped it onto my belt like that, and it still tilted forward, and I was basically just seeing whatever was about 2 feet in front of my toes. So that's kind of useless. I was able to clip it like that onto a thing that's on the handlebars of my bike. There's a Velcro wrap around that's got a little tool case on it, and that held fairly well. And I'll show you some footage of me riding around like that. Now, I was trying to ride relatively slow, and if you can see on the path is covered in goose shit. So I was trying to kind of steer around that so that it wouldn't get on my tire and flail up onto my back and just, yeah. So that's kind of what some of the unstable riding is. I also tried it. Well, okay, that was just using that. The other accessory that came with it is this thing here, which allows that to clip on there or there, and it's got this adjustable swivelly thing. And that's cool. I was actually using that up there, and there were some shots that I took previously, just experimenting, where I just screwed this to the wood that this camera's mounted on, which is my railroad actually, which is at my forehead level, give or take, above my workbench here. But I found that wasn't all that useful for a lot of other applications because I can't screw it to stuff much. So I screwed it to a couple of these little clamps. They are what, 2 inch by whatever is that, third of an inch or so wide. Just little spring clamps. I think I got them at a dollar store. I'm sure I got them at a dollar store because that's where I buy stuff. And those now can clamp onto all kinds of things. They open, let's see, what do they open? About 3/4 of an inch or so. And you can clamp onto all kinds of stuff. Right now, up here, I've just got a little chunk of Masonite screwed on beside the camera. And that's what I had them clamped onto there. I was able to clamp it onto different parts of my bike. for fun, I tried to clamp it onto the dog's collar and the sort of the walking harness that we have for the dog that goes, it's kind of a 4-point harness, goes around his chest and over his back and behind his legs. And it clamped onto there fairly well, but when he was walking, it bounced around like this horribly. So then I took it and just clamped it onto his collar, which was a lot more stable view, except for as he walked, the weight of this thing caused his collar to rotate around. And then we were looking at the world 90 degrees out of phase, which they're out of kilter. So that's, not sure about dog cam idea. The other thing I've noticed is the screw in the middle of this thing is really loose. And no matter how much I tighten it up, it seems to have bottomed out and it just spins, especially with the weight of this little camera on it. It's surprisingly heavy. The body's all metal. And through my experiments and dicking around generally, this thing got launched and dropped a couple of times. It landed in the grass more than once. It landed on the sidewalk at least once. So that wasn't ideal. So something else that I did is I stuck a little piece of adhesive back Velcro on the side there, which doesn't interfere with this. This can still clamp on the back. So I couldn't put it on the bottom because that's there. I couldn't put it on the top because it's got buttons. Couldn't put it on the side because there's the charge port / USB port and the SD card on the side. So the only place I could put it was on the left side. But then I can attach it to other stuff, such as this selfie stick handle, which I wrapped the other side of the adhesive back Velcro on, and then you can do that, or take some more of the adhesive back Velcro. I mean, when you buy that stuff, you don't buy an inch of it. You buy a meter or whatever, right? So, and I put the fuzzy, soft, fuzzy side on there, not the scratchy, nasty side. So that gives me a few other options to mount it on stuff. If I put it on a flat stick rather than this round thing, it sticks much better. But this is good enough for getting into quite a number of places where you can't get your hand. I mean, it wobbles around, but if you're not in motion, if you just have it stuck onto something, that works pretty well. The actual glass of the lens is recessed in. See me handling this pretty cavalier, right? But the actual glass of the lens is recessed in, so even when you set it down on the lens, it's not actually sitting on the lens. What else? Oh, yeah, the SD card. It's bitchy as hell to get in there. I needed tweezers or pliers or something. So after screwing around a couple of times, I just put a little bit of clear tape on there. And then I've got a handle to pull it out and stick it back in with. Which does it go this way, I think. There, yeah. And that doesn't really get in the way. This is the card I was originally using with it, and you see it kind of got scratched up with me using tools to pull it out all the time. Not ideal. And eventually, this card, it's an old one. It's 2 gig card. When was the last time you were actually even able to buy 2 gig SD cards? This thing somehow died. No computer I've got will read it. This thing won't read it. My phones won't read it. Doesn't even recognize it being plugged in. So I'm wondering if that little scratch in the back of here is through the paint enough into the guts of it that that's killed it. I don't know. Possibly. It died after I'd pulled it out and put it back in. It's possible. So what else is going on with this thing? So charges from USB. I already looked at that. Oh, I already mentioned that briefly. Oh yeah, there's a file on the SD card. As soon as you plug the SD card in, this thing writes a file to, well, it writes a couple of empty folders, a video and a photos folder, for obvious purposes. And then there's a file that it puts in the root directory, which I can't remember the name of it off the top of my head here. The file is called timerset. And basically, it has in it year, month, day, time, and either a yes, Y or an N, yes or no. So you have to pull the card out, put it into your computer, modify the contents of that file to today's date and time, maybe like 30 seconds or a minute in the future, and either Y or an N for yes or no if you want it to actually put the watermark on the frame down here with the time and date or not. Some of the video clips you've seen and you will see have it on. That was before I figured that out. Some of them have it off. That was after I got smart enough to read the book, translate it from Chinglish into real English in my brain, try it 6 or 7 times, kill an SD card, go buy a new SD card, and finally, I got it working. So that's the ones that you're seeing without it. What else? I talked about in the previous video, it says here it's got image proportion 4:3. That is only for the stills. The video is actually either 1280 by 720 or 1920 by 1080, which is standard 720p or 1080p. So that is not going to be cropped like this in the photos. You saw the photo of the dog standing outside in the leaves. That's cropped like that. But all the video is the right shape. However, this guy does have a narrower lens or narrower field of view. It's an accurate field of view. It's not zoomed. It's not an anti-fisheye lens or anything like that. My real dash cam in my truck, which is a Uniden 945, which is, what, $150 to $200 bucks, depending on where you buy it and whatnot. I actually tried this guy out with it. And that the unit has like 120 degree field of view. It's kind of fisheye. This thing is actually, as you've already seen, it takes a narrower picture than this one, just by the geometries of the lens. Sitting in the same position, well, you saw what it was, sitting in the same position, it's cropped in kind of there-ish, right, when you're viewing with this guy. So it's maybe not the best dash cam in the world. One mode it does have, if you plug USB power into it, not a computer, but just power, then it automatically starts up in 720 and in cycle record mode. Basically, it records 5-minute file, then records a second 5-minute file and keeps going until it runs out of room on the card, and then overwrites the oldest file. Standard dash cam stuff. So this one, I took my work truck and clipped it on using this. Just clipped it onto the power cable of the Uniden right beside it. It looked kind of dorky. It worked. Here's an artist's impression of how I installed it. And I drove around for a bit, and I'll show you some of that footage. There's only one area where, for some reason, it was overwriting files weirdly, and the dash cam's card was almost full, and it was overwriting files. So I only got actually a few minutes of video where they're both in the same place at the same time. And it's kind of going into the back lane right by my office, so I'm not going to show you that. What I will show you is just random driving down the streets. It was, as you can see from the timestamps, it was in the morning on my way to work. So the sun was up, but it wasn't above the buildings and trees yet. There are some bursts of full sun just as I'm driving along, but most of it is in indirect daytime light. And again, it turned out not too bad. I can, as a dash cam, as a cheap dash cam, as an $8 dash cam, I can, yeah, that I could recommend that for that. The video quality's not too bad. When you're pulled up at a stoplight or something, you can read the license plates of the other vehicles. In low light, however, it's kind of sucky. It gets really grainy, as any cheap cameras do. So what else did I try it on? Oh, then I tried to get creative and tried it in really unlikely places. I mounted it on the spokes of my bike. And if you're going to do that just to get that shot, you'd want this super duper loose, looser than it is right now. And you'd want some weight hanging below that so that the camera maintained its straight up and down. I didn't do that. It looks stupid. The dog camera pictures I think I showed you already. I stuck it on the top of the Roomba with some double-sided tape and cruised it around the living room for a while. That was kind of cool, actually. Pointless, sure, but kind of cool. What else? Oh, yeah. I used this guy just to take a peek at the inside of my cheap acoustic guitar. If you're doing a repair or planning a repair, that's not a bad idea to get a look around inside. For the illumination, I could have used the infrared mode, but instead I used one of these little four for a buck from China LED lights as the light. It's bright enough in there inside a dark guitar. Probably the best option would be to use this plus the infrared, because as you saw earlier, the infrared creates a very monochrome picture. But if your bridge pins are jammed or if there's a brace loose or something, that might be a good option to just get a preliminary view of what's going on in there. I also, while I had the guitar out, tried the standard rock and roll video pose. That again, that because I hadn't invented this thing yet, I just rolled some electrical tape actually over underneath there, stuck it on the headstock. Not too bad. And while I was thinking, hey, rock video mode, I put it on the corner of the keyboard, and that's okay, but you can get that shot easily with a phone or a better camera, whatever. So that's, you don't need something this tiny and light. What else? Oh, the one thing that I did show you that I was planning to do that I showed you in the previous video was use it for my model railroad. Check this out. This is probably the coolest thing that I did with it, and the thing that makes it worth the entire, $8 that I paid for it. That is just awesome. I love that. So I'm definitely going to use it for that, even and take it over to Buddy's Railroads and do video for them or whatever. I like that. That's great. What else did I try that failed miserably? I can't remember. I guess I'll just have to edit it in and voice over it later. So anyway, that's kind of a review. Oh yeah, did I show you that before? Yeah, that little hole there, that's the microphone. There's the four infrared illuminators. We saw that. The lens recessed in there so it doesn't get scuffed all to hell. The on-off button, which is also the start and stop record, and also the infrared on and off. The mode button, which goes between 720, 1080 still and back again. Card slot, USB. Yeah, a little reset button in there in case it gets horribly gibbled. Just poke a little sharp pokey bit in there, like a thumbtack or a convenient DuPont wire, because everybody's got those lying around. Don't you? What? Yeah, I don't know what else there is to say about this thing. Would I buy another one if this one got stolen or lost or fell down a toilet and got flushed down there? Actually, if it did, I would hope that it had infrared on, and I would hope that some plumber could get it back, because that would be interesting. Not saying I'm going to do that, or even suggest anyone else do it. That'd be like flushing $8 down the toilet. That wouldn't be good. But, and it probably wouldn't survive because the power connection and it's kind of open to the world here. So no, it wouldn't survive that. Don't do that. Unless you put it in a little plastic Ziploc bag. Nah, they're not very optical. All in all, for the money, cool toy. If you have a use for a camera that you need to fit in a really small place, yeah, it's not bad. Will it replace the camera on my phone here, which, just for reference, is a Samsung Note 4? No. Will it replace the Senyo camera that I used for my first dozen or two videos, and which I used earlier in this one for the shot of this camera sitting beside the one that I'm using right now? No, that one is, it's also a full HD camera proper. It can do 1080 60. Again, I keep it at 720 30 because that's what I edit at, that's what I upload at. Somebody in the comments is probably going to say, oh, why don't you upgrade, do everything at a higher rate? Because I don't need to. I'm not doing action shots. I'm not doing anything that I think needs full HD. 720 is a good balance for me. This thing does 720, kind of not bad. I'm going to keep it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions that I didn't cover in my rambling and ranting here, leave it in the comments below. I don't know if, hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it vaguely informative. There's lots of other videos out there on this thing. And if for whatever reason you want one, just search on your favorite source of Chinesium for SQ8 camera. You'll find tons of them. Sort by lowest price because why wouldn't you? Boom, done. Or search for, again, SQ8 camera on YouTube. You're going to find dozens of reviews of these things from people who actually know how to review cameras. And some of them have a lot better explanations of how to use it if you found mine confusing and weird. Yeah, there you go. Did I say goodbye already? Bye.